Alright, we didn't have to watch that. As we can see, I have lowered the sound so it's low enough so we can speak. And so my voice can be heard. We have a campaign here, new campaign. There are two campaigns. Eye of the Vertex, which is the original campaign, and the Mortal Empires, which is the world campaign. But you need Total War Warhammer 1 to be able to play this one. And I have both. I never played Total War Warhammer 1. I only bought it so I could get Mortal Empires. Alright, and the playable factions, we have Tyrion, the High Elves. His special units are the Silver Helms, Itilmar Chariots, and the White Lions of Kraith. Of course, we are going to use the mod which makes all the factions band together, so they will have all their starting legendary lords plus all the insignificant lords across the map. So all the High Elves will be together. So this is Tyrion. Let's see here. I don't know a lot about him, but alright, Teleth, he has Eagle Claw Ball Throwers, Sword Mothers of Huet, and Great Eagles. Tyrion had the Silver Helms, Itilmar Chariots, and White Lions of Kraith, so he's more cavalry based. This guy, Teleth, he has eagles and artillery, etc. Alright, I think he is more like a defender, while this guy is more offensive maybe. We have Alariel the Radiant, the Ever Queen. She has Sisters of Avalorn, Dryads, and Treecan as her unique units. So she is like... Alright, and then Alit Anar. Yes, Shadow Walker, Spearmen, and Great Eagles. Eltarion. He has Silvering Guard, War Lions of Kraith, and Arcane Phoenix. Eltarion. And then we have Imrik. I think he's the king or something. I'm not sure. Anyway, he has Dragon Princes, White Lions of Kraith, and Sun Dragons. So that's the legendary lords of the High Elves. Then we have the Lizard Man. Here we have Lord Masdamundi. All the Lizard Men will also be together as one faction. So Lord Masdamundi. He has Feral Bestiladon. He has Croxigors. And there's a Temple Guards unit. He looks like the leader, I'm not sure too. Alright, and we have the guy Krokgar. Additional starting units. Cold One Spear Riders, Feral Stegadon, and Saurus Spears with Shields. And then we have Tien Howin. And he has Salamander Hunting Pack. They can fire. They can shoot fire from their mouths. Bestiladon, Arkan Sotok, and we have Red Crested Skinks. So that's the Tien Howin guy. Then we have Tic Tac Toe. Additional starting units: Teradon Riders, Fire Leech Bolas, Skink Skirmishers, Cold One Riders. Flying hero, smaller one there, and we have Nakai the Wanderer, a big guy, crocodile-like guy. He only has two additional starting units: Sacred Croxigor and Croxigors. They are bigger units, probably that's why he only have two to balance him with the others. We have Gor Rock. And he has Skink Cohort, Javelins, and Saurus Warriors with Shields, and Saurus Spears with Shields. That's all legendary lords of the Lizardmen. We will look at the Dark Elves later. So here we have the Skaven, I believe. Quick Head Taker.
Clan Moors triumphant, yes, yes.
Clan Moors. Alright, and they have got the Runner Slingers. Got the Runner Slingers. Storm Vermin, Sword and Shield. Warp Lightning Cannons. So some good stuff there. Lord Skrulk of Clan Pestilence.
Will fall to pestilence.
They are more like plague versions. The pestilence. Rat Ogres, Plague Monks, and Plague Claw Catapults. So they are plague bringers. And then we have Tretch Craventail.
Many schemes soon, Rictus.
Doom Wheel. We have Death Runners, and we have Storm Vermin. This is Clan Rictus. They are starting close to the Dark Elven lands, I believe. Clan Moors, Pestilence is down in the Lizardman area.
Chief Master
Rictus is in our areas, or close to our areas. We have Ikkit Claw. Clan Scryer. Additional starting units. Rattling Guns, that's a good artillery unit. Warplock Yesiles, they have gunners. And Doom Flayers, very, very futuristic army this one. Dangerous army. Close to Stahl, they are till, so they are far from us. Far away from us. Deathmaster, Snicker. Alright, and he has Warp Grinders. The Runners and Ashen Triads. Alright, have another faction, Luthor Harkin, I believe it's the Pirate Vampire Coast. Yeah. Alright, Luthor Harkin, the leader probably. The Awakened. Alright, additional starting units. They are down in Lustria with the Lizardmen and the Pestilence Caven. So they have starting units here. Deck Droppers, Bloated Corpse, Mourn Ghouls. Right. We have Count Noctilus. The Dread Fleet. He's an admiral. Alright, additional starting units. Depth Guard, Zombie Pirate Gunnery Mob, and Necrofex Colossus. So he's a Colossus unit as well. He's in a small island there. And we have Aranessa Saltspite. She also has an island. Alright, additional starting units. Pirates of Sartossa, Isle of Sartossa, I see. So they have Sartossa Free Company, Deck Gunners, and Rotting Prometheans. Alright. Then we have Silostra Direfin.
The final act!
She is at the border almost. Now she is in down there in Lustria there. Yeah. Close to the others there. Right, she has Sirens, Caronades, pretty much cannons, I guess, and Mongols. So they will be one faction. So we have Tomb Kings. I'm not sure the Tomb Kings. I believe the Tomb Kings will be two factions. So we have Setra, the Imperishable. He will be one. Faction, I believe. He's down in close to Araby and the Orcs, etc. The Imperishable Khemri, alright. Additional starting units. Khemrian Warfinks. And the Skeleton Chariots. Tomb Guard with Halberds. We have Grand Hierophant Catap. He is close to the Dark Elven areas. I was wrong. This faction will be combined with some others There will be two factions. This guy is his own faction, Exiles of Nihek. Carrion. They have carrion birds, they have Nehekara warriors, and Hierotitan. Hierotitan. I'm not sure, but that's some unit. Alright. So they are independent. Then this guy, Setra the Imperishable, and High Queen Kalida. I believe they are close to each other. They might be the same faction actually. We have followers of Nagash. So High Queen Kalida, her unique units are the Sepulchral Stalkers, Worm-like creatures, Necropolis Knights, and Skeleton Archers. I believe she will be combined with Setra the Imperishable. And then Erkan the Black might be combined with Grand Hero Fand Katib. Alright, Erkan the Black. Erkan the Black. Additional starting units. Follower from the Gash. Tomb Scorpion. Fellbats. Crypt Golds. And now we're on the Empire, I believe. So we have Emperor Karl Franz himself. So Rakeland, additional starting units. They have the Rake's Guard, the Halberdiers, and the Handgunners. So, and yeah, the entire Empire faction will be one faction, I believe. We have Volkmar the Grim.
Sigma, grant me strength.
The Tattersoul's Flaglands. Knights of the Blazing Sun, Flagellants, I believe they are probably religious, these guys. They are like the religious part of the Empire. And then we had like the Pope. And then we have Balthasar Gelt, the Golden Order. So both of these are Rakeland, they will be combined, I believe. But the Golden Order is separate there. I believe they will still be one faction. Okay, the Golden Order, they have Outriders, Great Swords, and Morars. Mortars, alright. Marcus Wolfhart, he is in the New World, close to Lustria, so he's separate from the others. But he might still be a part of the Empire, maybe a far-off outpost. Alright, additional starting units, the Hunts Marshals Expedition. Archers, Huntsmen, War Wagons. And then we have the Dwarves. Thorgrim Grudgebearer, he will be the leader of all the Dwarves. There are three Dwarven factions plus some extras, I believe, that are unplayable. But that will be combined into one huge Dwarven faction. Okay, Thorgrim Grudgebearer.
To war!
So he is over there. close to the goblins in Sylvania. Karas A. Karak. Additional units. Hammerers. Grudge throwers. Quarrelers. Alright. Then we have Grom Brindal, the White Dwarf.
Our enemies shall tremble.
He is also in that area. He has additional starting unit. Gyrocopters. Brimstone Gun. That's a good unit. And Iron Drakes. And Miners Blasting Chargers. And then we have the third hero, Ungrim Iron Fist of Karak Kadrin.
The slayer in me seeks death.
He's a bit away from the others. Karak Kadrin. Additional starting units, Giant Slayers, Thunderers, and Slayers, alright. And then we have the Orcs and Goblins, I believe. There will be one faction as well. Grimgar Ironhide is their leader. So they start in Death Pass here. Grimgar's Ard Boys, the main faction. Additional starting units, Orc Bowl Boys, Black Orcs, and Doomdriver Catapults. Then we have Bursag, the Great Green Prophet. The Bloody Hands. Additional starting units, and they start close to the Eastern Badlands. They have Savage Orcs, Savage Orc are boys, and a Giant. So we have the Savage Orcs and Black Orcs there. Grom the Punch, Broken Axe. So this is the new guy from the recent update of the game. He has Snotling Pump Wagons, Spiky Rollers, and River Trolls and Stone Trolls. So he's a little different, he's a goblin, not an orc. And then we have Ashag the Slaughterer, Bone Ratlass. Additional starting units, Forest Goblin, Spider Rider, Archers, Goblin Rock Lobbers, Trolls, so pretty much a faction with goblins and trolls, but also orcs. Alright, and then we have this faction, Sylvania, Manfred von Karstein. So he has Varguli, Fellbats, Crypt Ghouls. Hellman Gorst, magic is mine to command. And he has Corpse Cart, Grave Guard, and the Dire Pack, Dire Wolves. So it's Dire Wolves. They start in the same area. We have Vlad von Karstein. The world will drown in blood. And he has Fellbats, Blood Knights, and Warghasts. Then we have Isabella von Karstein. Or Isabella von Karstein. She has Crypt Ghouls, Black Knights, and Crypt Ghouls. So two units of Crypt Ghouls. Then we have Heinrich Kemmler. Find me grave bound. He starts in a different area completely. They will probably all be united too. And he has Hex Wraiths, Cairn Wraiths, and Dire Wolves. And we have the Norsken faction. Where's my next quarry? Wulfric the Wanderer is the leader. He starts not far away from the Kislev areas and the Empire. Alright. And he has Marauder Ice Wolves chariots, Marauder Berserkers, and Skin Wolves. Cool faction, but I wish they had female shield maidens added too, because they forgot about the female shield maidens for the Norsken faction. Alright, and then we have Trog. There are only two Norsken factions. However, there are some unplayable minor factions as well that will be on their side, I believe. But Wulfric the Wanderer and Trog here, Troll, starts a bit to the east of the other army. Alright, Wintertooth, he has Norsken Warhounds, Norsken Trolls, and Norsken Ice Trolls. Then we have Britonia, Lowen Leoncower. Wait a second. So we have Lowen Leoncower, and he starts in Curon, and he's probably the king of Britonia. He has Field Trebuchets, Knights of the Realm, and Pegasus Knights. So that's pretty good starting force there. Then we have Alberic the Bordax, starting in Bordax. He has Knights of the Realm, Knights of Errant, and Foot Squires. Not as good units, but that's to be expected. He's more of a general, I believe, or knight of the faction. Alright, and we have the Fey Enchantress, starting in Carcassonne. And she have Blessed Field Trebuchets, Grail Guardians, and Battle Pilgrims. All of these factions will be united as one faction. We have Repance de Lyonnais, like Friendly Arc, I believe. Britonia is pretty much a fancy version of France. in the medieval age. So this is pretty much from the arc. Anyway, she starts in the eastern part of the coast of Arabia. So she's on a crusade, it seems. She has additional starting units, the questing knights, foot squires, and knights of the realm. Then we have another faction, wood elves.
Shield,
we have their king, Orion. He starts in the southeast part of the forest here, down here in Talzin. His additional units are Eternal Guard, Wild Riders, and Deepfoot Scouts. So they have like... they have like... I forgot the name, anyway, the word. Anyway, so the Wood Elves are there. They only have two factions here, but I believe they are at least four factions on the map. Two minor factions, probably. That would mean that they will all be united as well. We have Durtu in the upper north part of the forest. Probably these are AI controlled usually. Alright. And they have Dryads, Wild Riders, and Treekin. Let's show all. So I don't have the beast, man, that's surprising. I can't place the beast, man, then. If you look at them, they have Kazrak, the one eye. That are close to Tilia. And their special units are Goreherd, Minotaurs, and Goreherd. Not that good units. Malagor, the Dark Omen. Additional starting units, Chaos Warhounds, Poison, Giant, and Ungor Spearman Herd with shields. Right, and then we have Morgul Shadow Gabe. And he has Chaos Warhounds with Poison, Harpies, and Chaos Spawn. So I can't use the Beastmen, but they will be in the campaign as AI controlled. And they will have, I believe some factions doesn't have the United feature, the automated Confederate feature. Alright, then we have Archaon, the Ever Chosen of the Warriors of Chaos. I can use the Chaos faction. Alright, Warriors of Chaos, Archaon, the Ever Chosen. So he starts in the Chaos Wastes here. Original starting units, he has Chaos Warriors, Chosen great with great weapons, and Chaos Warriors with halberds. Then we have Kulek Sun Eater. He also starts down there. He has Chaos Warriors with halberds, Chaos Warriors, and Dragon Ogres. Pretty much Centaurs. Alright, Prince Sigwald the Magnificent. He looks a lot like Artus from Warcraft 3. Alright, and he also starts down there. He has Hell Cannons, Chosen with Halberds, and Chosen. Alright, now let's take a look at the Dark Elves. So we have Malus Darkblade. He starts far away from the other Dark Elves, down in the Dragon Isles. Hag Graef is his faction, his minor faction name. He has Cold One Knights, Blood Rat Medusa, and Scour Gunner Chariots. Scourge Runner Chariots. Alright. Then we have Lockyer Fellheart. Spawns on an isle close to the Southern Great Jungle. He has Dark Shards with shields, Feral Manticore, and Black Orc Corsairs with handbows. Then we have Crone Hellebron, starting in the Road of Skulls there. She will look slightly different in the game due to the mod, but the video is the old look here. She has Horganet Executioners, Sisters of Slaughter, and Dread Spears. And we have Morati, the mother of Malekith. She starts in the Titan Peaks. And she has War Hydra, Witch Elves, and Dark Riders with Repeater Crossbow. And she will also look different. Malekith, the King of the Dark Elves, starts in Nagaron here in the Iron Mountains. And he has Colvan Chariots, Blackguard of Nagarond, and Reaper Bolt Throwers. Now it makes sense to play as Malekith because we are playing the entire faction and he is the King of the Dark Elves. However, the different lords have different playstyles. If I play, for example, as Crone Hellebron, she has unique features for her that I won't be able to use unless I choose her. For example, Black Ark, Slaves, Murderous Provess, if you look at race attributes, but if you look at Lord, there are different gameplay mechanics based on the Lord. I will choose Malekith because he's the king of the Dark Elves. And we will use very hard battle. As for campaign, yeah, we might use normal there, so it won't be too hard. I'm a newbie in this game after all. And then start the campaign. For too long, the Dark Elves have squatted in their adopted homeland of Nagaroth. It is time that Malekith brought the world under his dominion. From his capital Nagaroth, the Witch King shall quickly bring any rebellious dreadlords to heel and then set about conquering the world. All beings are Malekith's thralls and slaves, even if they don't yet know it. Yeah. The most we will ally the orcs, maybe. But otherwise, he is pretty much hostile to anyone, so. And he will use the orcs as slaves, so yeah. Or manipulate them.
Hail, dread scourge Malekith. You rule over a splintered people. Your realm is in decay. And there are many vile creatures who will attempt to stop your advance. The Druki are fractured, yet many still know loyalty to your rule. Others, however, do not, and need bringing to heel. If they do not bend the knee to the Witch King, then they should be destroyed utterly. Beyond the northern watchtowers lurk the savage tribes of men, petty worshippers of the dark powers. Their ceaseless attacks upon your realm must end with their annihilation. In the meantime, you should unify the Druki through either statecraft or by destroying would-be opposition. All will bow to the Witch King. All will yield to Malekith.
So, here is the mod configuration tool. Basic mod settings. Warn on Lua error. Warn me. Don't warn me. I don't know what that means. What that error is. Maybe we should have it on warn me. Abandon region mod. So turns until regions are abandoned, we will make it one turn like in a Tilatul War. And public order penalty, no penalty, we will have a public order penalty. Public order penalty scope, global penalty or local, I will make it local. It makes sense that the population of the region you abandon will not like that you abandon them to their fate, but I don't like global penalty. Public order, penalty settlement tire based. Yes, enable. Right, then we have the region full visibility mod. Defensive alliances. Yeah, I think they could be visible. Logger, what does that even mean? Region for logger, no, I don't need that. Military alliances, visible. Own regions visible. And vassal visible. That's fine. I want to see my defensive allies too. Alright, and legendary confederation. Legendary confederations. That's the coolest mod. So mod status, it will be on. And then theaters of war mode. Include regions and armies. It's off by default, but with this mod configuration tool we can change that. So I will set this on. So now we have the theaters of war mode on. So we will not only get the legendary heroes of Malekith, Helebron, and Morati, but we will also and the extra heroes of Malice Darkblade and Lockyer Fellheart. But we will also be getting their armies and their starting regions. Deadl Alliances mode, AI Confederations. On main fact is off by default. On if we click on this on main factions, takes a few seconds to load. The playable legendary lords confederate with their own to form super factions. So all the playable lords will confederate, even the AI ones. The other options only did it for the players faction. But now if I have this on, all the playable legendary lords of all factions, including the AI controlled ones, will confederate into super factions. So that's more fun, I guess. But then we have the on world war. What's the difference between these? Yeah, all factions, not just the legendary lords, join together to form super factions. So instead of having the minor factions still remain neutral AI controlled factions or hostile AI controlled factions, we will have a world war where all the dark elves are together, all the high elves are together, etc. And I like that. Then we have player one, confederation with the blessed dread, confederation with the cult of pleasure, confederation with Hagraeff and Harganet. The blessed dread is Locker Fellow's faction, the cult of pleasure is Morati's faction, Hagraeff is the faction of Malus Darkblade, and Harganet is the faction of Helebron. We will use the World War setting and have all these settings on. And finalize. So the loading ended there. You can see here. We are controlling areas there. How they play Nagarons, slaves. Dark Elf factions capture slaves in battle. Slaves provide additional income, but can negatively affect public order. Slaves can also be sacrificed to perform rites. Black Ox, by performing a sacrifice to Matlan rite. Dark Elf factions may summon a naughty Black Ark. These powerful floating fortresses can be used to attack enemy ports, raise armies, recruit units, and support invasion forces with aerial bombardments. Learn more about Dark Elves. Right. Chapter objective issued. Vengeance Incarnate. Occupy, loot, raise, or sack 4 different settlements. Current total 33 out of 4. Yeah, we kind of started with 33 areas now, so we've already done that. It will give us this reward: treasury plus 2,000, treasury plus 2,000 from bonus objectives. So description: the frozen lands of the Nagaroth are a far cry from the glimmering beauty of Ultuan. But it is the Druchi home now, so they will claim as much of it as possible and forge a new kingdom from the shield wastes. All right, ownership. So we own these areas that are in purple here. We also own the little isle down there, where Lockheer Fellheart is. And we own this isle here, of Malice Darkblade. Dragon isles there. Alright, and all of these areas, but there are Chaos armies here and Skaven. Even though we have disabled the spawning armies, so there might be some armies that won't show up now. Alright, and yeah, we have some Tomb Kings here too. We need to cleanse these areas of other factions, while at the same time defending, because the Ultuan is now united as well, the Elves of Ultuan. And the lizard man. Let's click on choose or die here. Choose or die. Some choices require next to no thought whatsoever. Income from slaves plus 3. We will upgrade that technology. And alright. I don't need that. Visible. We have Malekith here, summary, details. So capital of the Dark Elves is Naggarond. Provinces owned are 6. Settlements owned are 34. Treasury is 6,000. So we are kinda out of money for having such a huge empire already. Income, we have 701 gold per turn, I believe. Or we're minus 701. Faction effects, Witch King of Naggarond. Alright. Faction power, we are number 16 in the world. I don't know how many factions there are. Alright. Let's take a look at the diplomacy screen. So we have Beastmen, they are divided into two factions currently, but we can only see parts of the world. And the parts we can see, we have the Manblight tribe. Their strength is 39. So that's not the best. We have the Shadow Gore Warherd. They don't seem to be allied to anyone or at war with anyone. Shadow Gore Warherd is on place 41. Comes to their strength. We have the Greenskins, they only have one army. Grimgor's Odd Boys. There might be more, maybe. We might just not have found them yet on the map. But this faction alone is at place 24 in strength, while our faction is at place 17. So we are counted as stronger. They don't have any allies or enemies. We have Eatane of the High Elves, the only faction. They are place 19. Two places below us. We are slightly stronger than the High Elves. And they don't have any allies or enemies either. We have the Lizard Men, place 30. They're Hexoatl. Yeah, it was the fat guy. They are at war with the Blue Vipers, an undiscovered faction. No allies. And then we have the Norskans. We can only see the World Walkers. They are at place 25. They are at war with the Crone faction, undiscovered faction. And then we have a rogue army. The Tyrants of the Black Ocean. A Dark Elven army. Place 2, which is surprising.
What dark and callous plans do you wish to lay before me?
We will have a military alliance with them, because they are Dark Elves. So I did use this diplomacy sheet, so we can just bribe them with 300 gold and they will accept anything. So now we are allied to Dastan Koldai and his army of Dark Elves. Let's take a look at his army. Can't accept a Dark Elf army to be independent. Alright, he has an army here. He has Blackguards of Naggarond, Blackguard of Naggarond, Blackguard Corsairs, Blackguard Corsairs with handbows, Dark Shards with Shields, Doomfire Warlocks on Hellsteeds, Dark Riders with Repeater Crossbow, also mounted on like Hellsteeds, and then Charybdis, a great twisted monster Hydra, a mutated Hydra, and then we have the Feral Manticore, two of those, and Reaper Bolt Throwers too. So he had a pretty strong force. His country is number 2 in the world. His army is not to be messed with, and he's an ally now. So this is the Tyrants of the Black Ocean. Alright, let's go back to the diplomacy screen. We have Skaven on the one faction, Clan Scryer. They are at place 26, are at war with Istalia. They are not a threat to us, they are on the other side of the ocean. I'm not sure we will have any clan Reptic or clan Septic or whatever, because I removed the spawning armies. Maybe they counter the spawning. Maybe that was unnecessary now, because we have so huge factions that those factions would be kind of easy to handle even for the AI, I believe. I mean, they have all their factions combined, so... Anyway, we will try to play like this. And we have the Tomb Kings. They have two factions, the Court of Liberas, under the High Queen Kalida, over here. Down there, and then we have the Exiles of Nihek and the Grand Hero Pant Catep. So they are divided in two factions. And we have the Vampire Coast with one faction,
King
the Awakened.
Of the Vampire Coast.
Led by the King of the Vampire Coast. He has one enemy. Vampire Coast Mutineers, undiscovered faction, I see. And the Exiles of Nihek. Nihek is at war with the Rippertorn tribe.
High Queen Kalida.
Alright. So we have lots of regions. Can't zoom out more than this. I didn't use the other mod that enabled us to, that would enable us to zoom out even further. Quite the empire here, all the way down here. So we can take a look at some stuff. So that's the mini map there. Event. So I got rid of that thing. Right, events. You're not interested in that. Lords and heroes. We have Malekith himself over there. He has some unique stuff there. So we have Black God of Nagaron, Dread Spears, Dark Shards, Cold One Chariots, and Reaper Bolt Throwers. Morati. Similar units, but she has Dark Riders, War Hydra, and the Vigils. We have already gone through Hurry troops and Hellebron's troops and Lockyer Fellheart's troops. And the troops of Malice Darkblade over here. However, we can take a look at the minor factions. We have Exarian. He seems to have Black Orc Corsairs, Bleak Swords, Dread Spears, and Black Orc Corsairs with hand bows. Some unique stuff. We have Alyssa. More of the same. Shaquilil. It's more of the similar units there. All the minor factions seem to have the same starting armies. Volilosh. Galadriel. Shakara. and not crush it. He has an area very close to the High Elves. They are there, I see. Not crush it. All of them have the same troops. Lords and heroes. We have Yrkithar, and he has some unique stuff. He has Reaper Bolt Throwers, Dark Swords with Shields, yeah. And Losi, same as the others. We have an Admiral with Black Orc Corsairs and Trips there. And that was Admiral Kanovakil. And here we have Admiral Leech. Similar units. We have Dratella, a hero, I believe. And some other heroes. Alright, we have four heroes in total, or five. Anyway, down there, provinces. We have all of these provinces. Nagarit, Obsidian Peaks, Phoenix Gate, the Broken Lands, the Shield Road, and the Titan Peaks. We also have Avalorn. Deadwood. Doom Glades, Dragon Isles, Headhunter's Jungle, Iron Mountains, Black Coast, Black Flood, the Clawed Coast, and the Road of Skulls. Other provinces. You don't have those, right? Known factions, so we know the factions we already viewed. We have 5,700 left for our stash. Alright, so here we have the World Walkers. So we have cameras, setting spell browser. Help pages, advisor, chat, menu. Alright. So let's take a look at all our provinces then. To start in the Iron Mountains, Nagarond. So we have a mod on that will enable us to view this. We can see we build this one, conscription halls. We have it from start. Then we got the Bleak Swords, the Dread Spears, and the Dark Shards. You can also see them more closely here. Dark Shards, Bleak Swords, and Dread Spears. And then the next building will allow us to get Devoted of Slaanesh, Pit Fighters, and Dark Shards with Shields. And we can look here for the units specifically too. Alright. So we are building Dark Elf Harbors there. Then we will move to another region. In Hag Hall. We could build a livestock pens, and they will growth plus 40, casualty replenishment rate plus 6%, recruitment cost minus 15% for Dark Riders and Doomfire Warlock units. So we get minus 15% recruitment cost for the cavalry there. Then we have recruit rank plus one for Dark Riders and Doomfire Warlocks. Alright, we will build that. And let's move to the next. In SSL Rator. We will see what we can build there. Plateau of Dark Steeds, we'll build that. We only have 700 gold left now, or whatever the currency is called here. Missed an area there. So we can build Dark Elf Manors, we will do that. 200 left. Don't think we have enough money now for anything. We're done. All right. Maybe we could move our armies and such. Malekith, the king of the Dark Elves, here. We'll move into Naggarond. Don't have enough money to build anything. We have an agent here. We could move. Let's move her there.
I know the way. To misery.
Can't do anything there. She will just move past them. This is Clan Scryer. All of them are Clan Scryer now. I believe the Skaven have united into one single faction, no matter where they are on the map. So the Skaven are one faction there. Alright. So we should have garrison in each of the settlements. Building browser, garrison details, yeah. We have lots of garrisons defending each and every settlement. But they will become better when we upgrade. When we build buildings and upgrade cities, they will get better garrison troops. We only have the basics in most places. Alright. Recruit heroes, we can't recruit anything right now. Same with the Black Ark or the Lords. Don't have money for lords. Alright. Might have some more heroes to move, but before Lord that we might want to move armies. So we have Hellebron here, she will move into Harganet. And this sorceress will move towards this place.
As you say.
So, have another army here, Morathi herself, move into the ancient city of Quintex there, we have some hero here, Kanita Assassin, let's move him closer to the border with High Elves. Here we have Lockyer Fellheart.
Tyrant of Naggarond. Dreadlord of Naggarond. The ocean awaits.
See.
Sacrifices to Mathlan. Show me the compass.
So that's Lockyer Fellheart there. Moving back to the city here, Shippajotl. Now Malice Darkblade. There's an enemy arm here. Hexoatl. All the lizardmen of one faction, yes. They are also huge.
By the Lord of Murder.
Black-hearted Dreadlord.
All right. Guess we will just attack. Because they are too many here. You need to attack. Declare war. Tyrants of the Black Ocean. So they refuse to join us. But we are still enemies. Yeah, they are. Yeah.
Slaughter them all!
So they seem to have a slight upper hand here. So their army consists of. Their leader is Alasanesic. And they have some Saurus warriors, red crested skinks, feral cold ones. So they have some cold one cavalry. They have feral Bastilladon, and they have the Croxigurs giants. Alright, and we have Malice Darkblade, who is possessed by a demon. He can turn into demon form sometimes during battle. And he has bleak swords, red spears, red dark shards, and cold one knights. He even has Scourge Runner chariots and a blood rack Medusa. And we have the AI controlled army from the settlement. Settlement garrison, bleak swords, red spears, dark shards. They seem to be weak, the allied army. Probably they are from. I believe they are from. The Black Ark ship. Alright, let's play the battle. So our ally only has 54 units because they were kind of weakened to start. They have a slight advantage in this battle, but it would only get worse if we let them, if we waited. Battle starts. Let's take a look at the troops, but before that we could look at the we seem to have an advantage right now. Allied troop count, we have 512 troops, soldiers, out of 1022, and enemy troop count 467 out of 467. So we only have half an army. We should have twice our size, but that's because our allied force, we're kind of in a weakened state. Here we can see Murderous Prowess. The Murderous Prowess ability will trigger once this many combatants have been killed. Heal 0 out of 350. So when we have killed 350 enemies, we will trigger Murderous Prowess. Alright, and also the map is cool. We could zoom it out like this. Here we have three armies. Army ability: Sky Quadron, Soul Rain, Kane Slash. No, that's abilities. Let's take a look at the army now first. So we have a mod which enables us to zoom out like this. Pretty cool. We have our army here. Take a look at the army. We can see that we have some dark shards here. Ordinary dark shards. We have some hero here. Might be. It's an officer. So the mod worked that added officers to each unit. That's cool. Unless he is Malice Darkblade or something. Let's take a look for to be certain. Yeah. No, this is Malice Darkblade himself. When he isn't in the demonic form. We have some dark shards with shields. No, these are bleak swords. I'm pretty sure. Bleak swords, yes. Are they different sizes? I'm not sure. They have officers in each unit, so it worked. Awesome. They are just not at the side like in Medieval 2, they are in the middle of the unit. Cool with officers. And then we have the unique unit. Scourge Runner Chariots. Hellsteeds. Driving them like this or whatever they are called. So they are like crossbowmen. Crossbow chariots. We have some cavalry. Cold One Knights. Should be an officer here somewhere too. We have Dark Shards here. The officers are melee. Alright. We have the Hydra too. Name is Bloodwrack Medusa. I said wrong, it wasn't the Hydra, it was the Bloodwrack Medusa. You can also zoom in extra on units thanks to a mod. So this is extremely zoomed in. The mod which makes her naked instead of having armor. They are also stronger than in the past. Alright. Same with these units. When I zoom in, I can zoom in extremely far. Also, I have mods that enabled me to zoom in very low. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 units in total. So we place them under AI control. And start the battle. I like cinematic views. Where are the rest of the army too? Did they disappear? Let's pause. Ah, they are here. Dark Blade and the others. They started that far away. These are very fast. These units are over here. They may have moved back to get the higher ground. I believe they did. Alright. So we are using large unit sizes because anything else would be too demanding when there are huge armies on the battlefield. It would lag. Our cavalry, some bleak swords coming there, or whatever it is. The enemy forces arriving here. That giant unit there, Croxigors. And the troops have started to move. Cavalry is already fighting. Fighting some wild cold ones there. Maybe the name is different. Like the animations. We should win that battle. We can see here, our bleak swords are now fighting their troops here, can't remember their names. Like the mod that makes it so that they stand in line like this. Let's take a look at the rest of the battlefield. Giant beast savaging our troops here. They are holding their lines there against these dinosaur creatures. That thing is no joke. Malus Darkblade himself there, killing some troops, killing some dinosaurs there. We have the Hydra. Alright. Isn't she going to do anything? She did some blasting attack there. Seems they have the upper hand in this battle. There is a lord. Some legendary lord there. But Medusa is doing her best to defend. Our troops here are about to get swamped, but they haven't retreated. That's very good. Our Cold One Knights have joined the battle, but they have fucking Croxigors here. They died, two of them. They have more too. Our army is not defeated, as far as I can see. Their armies seem to be fleeing. Medusa is shooting that blast. For their fleeing armies, we have Malus Darkblade himself walking casually there. It will be murder. Lizard men are retreating. They don't have unlimited morale. was afraid I would actually win against the Medusa and the others. Magics are going on there. Wonder what that is. I'm not used to the magics. Play this game in February for a week or so, but never really understood the magics. Let the AI control the mages, etc. Down like this too.
Good. Outstanding. It will be murder. At once. I am death. Now. Suffering for all. Outstanding.
Giant creature approaching.
It will be murder. Of course.
So we'll fight a campaign as the entire Dark Elven faction and see how far we can go, if we will be defeated or not. Unlike in Medieval 2, I'm a total noob playing this game, that's why I prefer placing them under the AI. I tried playing myself and I usually got beat. The Kruxigors have returned! Fighting the Kolvan Knights there. So our troops are retreating, but we won the battle. They retreated now.
Bloody murder. Death.
See.
With pleasure.
And they are killed off. One guy is still. Two guys are still alive. They run down there.
Hack, cut.
Malice Darkblade himself hurt. Battle was a success.
Slaughter them. Slay them.
This giant beast is still trying to leave the battlefield. Let's take a look here. Allied troop count 224 out of 1022. We started with around 500 something. Enemy troop counts 0 out of 467. Some of them have still to leave the battlefield too. It's being forced to the side by your cavalry. You'll probably manage to flee. There it went. So we still have the problem of the heroes leaving battlefield instead of fighting to death. That's okay in battlefield battles, but I don't want that in siege battles. But if I use a unlimited morale code or mod, I mean, then also all the units would have that feature too, which would be unfair to the undead. So a skink there. Him. end battle. So yeah, they got crushed. Malice Darkblade deployed 467, lost at 281, remaining 186. Elret had 54, lost at 5, 49 remaining. The enemy Alcan Sick 467 deployed, 425 lost, 42 remaining. Alasan Sick was the enemy. We needed to fight that battle. Could enslave them. Slaves reduce the load of on the troops, making recovery more swift. Units replenishment by 6%. Slaves 84. Murder captives. Recruit rank plus 100 for all units. Alright, and leadership plus 2. Ransom captives. It's the worst one. Treasury is 740, but. Casualty replenishment rate minus 2%, leadership minus 2. Alright, murder captives.
Your servitude will be my
can't really see. On the other hand, we are using cold ones in our army.
Void awaits them.
Murder captives. The murder of captives provides a pleasing and instructive entertainment. Your army will gain the following effect. Murdered captives. Turns one, the recent murder of captives was a pleasing and instructive entertainment for this force.
The quotas
right.
Must be filled. Flay their paltry souls.
I think we will
there is beauty in
ruin rank. We will murder them.
Get moving.
Enemy killed in battle. Alessansic. Sansik, our enemy belonging to Hexuadl, has perished in the battle at Dragon Fang Mount. Dragon Isles. Alright.
Dark Blade! Into the stronghold!
So we have entered the stronghold. Merge selected units. Fuck, I clicked the wrong button there.
Unscrupulous. Ready.
We won't disband any unit. So we have merge dues. Have a hero here. A master hero.
Progress.
We can have this map fully visible like this too. Entire map is huge. So we're in this little area here.
What now?
Tyrant of the Hag.
Rename. don't think we will do enough of that now.
Black-hearted dreadlord.
Short-sighted. Your plans are foolish.
All right. An army here as well. Ixarian.
Vicious dreadlord. What? What now? Dreadlord.
I don't know what we should do with him.
Murderous lord.
Maybe we could recruit some units. We earned some money after that battle, I guess. But I want that other guy to have money then. I mean, have more troops. He needs more troops, he's far away.
Yes.
So we will add some more troops to him. Right.
Supreme sorceress.
We need Galadriel to get more troops. Sekulil.
Tyrant of Nagel.
Right, I think about it, he has an army threatening him from this side, from the east. And then we have another army threatening Grond here. We need to attack both of them.
Dark sorceress.
This army could actually move towards the Skaven.
Chosen of Hecate, scream for me. It will have to wait.
Malekith, king of Nagaroth.
So Malekith's army is there. Here we have another army under Alyssa. So the army of Volilosh will merge with the army of Alyssa. We will move Shakara's army as well. So we can get some great armies together. Here we have Volilosh
and
enemy army there.
Dreadlord, at your command. We rest first. Not now. Later.
Svår vid Clan Skryre. It's about to happen there. We also have the Tomb Kings or whatever this is. The Expine Mount. Yeah. Tomb Kings. Let me. För Xerian into the Tomb King area, Tomb King's area there. If they are too strong, we'll just retreat.
Dreadlord, awaiting command. What awaits me?
We will move Nelossi to closer to Morati. Combine their strengths.
Look here, Bellhart.
All right, we're down there.
Lord of Nagara.
I've had a lord here as well.
Tyrant.
No crusade. It's moving closer to the other army there.
Lord of the Black Court.
All right.
Finding my way.
Elisa, your region here. She can't do anything right now. Skip that step. Treasury, summary. Alright. That's not very important. Another area here. Nothing to do right now. Here we have an army. Here, kit her. It already moved. Malice Darkblade has leveled up. So, 2 points, I believe. Let's see here. Route Marcher. Those who know the land and its secrets will travel faster, further than the foes who don't. Campaign movement range plus 10%. Inspiring presence. There are lords that radiate power, confidence and fear, inspiring their followers to great or terrible acts. Characters, aura, leadership effect plus 5%. Aura. Any unit standing within this character's aura in battle will receive a leadership bonus. See Dragon Cloak. The tough, scaly hide of the sea dragon provides excellent protection against all manner of blows. Armor plus 5. I prefer this one. Devastating charge. Some creatures charge home with such fury that the very ground shakes beneath their feet. Charge bonus plus 15. Hard to hit. Hand-to-hand combat is a lethal match of cut and thrust. However, it's not all about offensive strikes. Parries and other defensive moves can also be win the day. It's not all about offensive strikes. Parries and other defensive moves can also win the day. Lead defense plus 6. Short bonus plus 15. Blade master. This warrior is one with their blade. Is an extension of their will, making them a worthy foe in combat. Melee attack plus 6. And indomitable. The iron will and indomitable presence of this leader ensures their followers remain steadfast and facing peril. Plus 6. Charge bonus. Defense. Attack. Leadership. Here we go for leadership then. And the next turn. And now we can just fast forward there. Make it much faster. Black Council, Shrekhulil. Rumor has it that Estressor has been asking questions about you. He is said to be Malekith's spy master on the Black Council, though there is no proving it. If he could be coerced, Malekith may think more highly of you. Do not interfere. Unhappy populace, loyalty plus 1. Curse him, loyalty minus 1, happy populace. Population order plus 6. And, yeah. Curse him. Sunless Seas, Alyssa. Do suspicious Nurky mountain-dwelling shade tribe, the Knives of Cain, approach you, asking for assistance to chart the underworld sea. If they can find better routes across the continent, then all Dark Elves will benefit. Aid them. Attrition. Enables attrition for this army. This army is suffering attritional losses due to a recent event. Loyalty plus 1. Decline your assistance. Loyalty minus 1. Alright, aid them.
Your prestige grows, my lord. News of your conquest spreads far and wide. Your developing power is noted by even the most distant of kings and bestial lords. Grave news, my lord. Word is spreading across the land of a dark power rising in the northern wastes. The armies of Chaos are on the move. They surely plan to invade the world of mortals once again.
Oi. Oh, shit. Huge army of Chaos has spawned. The rise of Chaos! Dire tidings from the north. The tendrils of chaos writ and reach our from the cursed wastes, tainting the land and sowing dissent. Their corrupt forces wax ever stronger. and now their agents are abroad, spreading the full corruption of their malign gods. On their heels come bands of marauding warriors led by the most zealous of the Chaos Lords, eager to wreak destruction in the name of the Runous powers. And all the while, ever more warriors flock to some local point in the Chaos Wastes, a nexus of power which transcends their petty rivalries and imperials and impulse them to join with a numberless horde. Doom approaches, and it is only in strength that any hope may be found. Bankrupt, Nagaron. Our coffers are empty. This will have dire consequences for our dependents, and soon. Ruchi Ascendant, occupy loot, raise and sack 8 different settlements. Current total 0 out of 8. Description. It was by the Druchi's hands that the sundering was brought about. Malekith's forces dueled with the Azur for control of the Great Vertex, and the struggle resulted in a savage cataclysm that rendered the world asunder. Malekith would see that agony if he could. Malekith would see that again if he could. Treasury plus 2000 in reward. Alright. An Age of Discovery. The raging sea god Stronifels has gone missing. Perhaps blown too far south by the arcane temples that is consuming the world. With his absence, the great ocean is becalmed. The denizens of this world sense an opportunity. It is now no longer for the elves to dominate the seas alone. Other powers seek to ply the oceans, hunt for treasures, and expand their empires abroad. However, they must not mistake a calm sea for a safe one. There are still countless dangers lurking in the deeps. All major port owners have become known to each other via diplomacy. Alright, let's take a look at the diplomacy then. So beastmen are now 3. We have the Ripper Horn tribe controlling this isle here. They are at war with the exiles of Nihek. And then we have the Manblight tribe and the Sarugor warherd. We have Britonia, Coron, because they had a port. They are now available. Coron. They are probably just one faction. They are countless number 6 in strength. Ripperhorn tribe is just 47. Manblight tribe is now 42. Shavrogor warherd is 41 still. So Coron is number 6 in the world. Nagaron Dark Elves are ranked number 1. So we are the strongest faction in the world. So that's cool. The Orcs, the Grimbor's Art Boys are number 2. Just below us. The High Elves are number 4. On turn 2, the stats changed to what they should have been in the first one. Alright, Exoatl is number 9, the Lizardmen. Norskan Worldwalkers are number 7. Tyrants of the Black Ocean are number 13 now. Clan Skryre is number 5. Stalia is number 32. So they aren't that strong. The Empire Rakeland is number 8. Then we have the Tomb Kings. Tomb Kings The Court of Liberas is number 26, and Exiles of Nihek is 31. Vampire Coast, the Dread Fleet, is number 18, and the Awakened is number 28. They aren't entirely united either. So, that's the situation currently.
What's best for me?
Damage walls, dreadlock, of course.
It is little surprise.
Hero activity, damage walls, success. Malarner has damaged the walls of Dreadrock. Malarner, our hero, has successfully infiltrated the settlement of Dreadrock. Dragon Isles. Good.
What plot?
We need more troops. 800. Maybe we shouldn't focus on troops currently. We could focus on the cities first. I'm worried about the economy, that it's so bad now because we started with everyone. Let's play Able. Right, let's take a look at settlements. In the Titan Peaks, we could build a crafting district. Here, House of Mustering. I prefer House of Mustering there. Here we get an iron mining pit. We have no more money now. We don't need troops currently. Alright, so the Chaos Fleets are vast. I wonder where they will go. Take a look at the armies here. They will move towards the Chaos troops there. Selulil will move there. Sekhulil will move there. Alright, Caladriel move towards the Skaven there. Skaven here. Want to attack them. Skaven revealed. Declare war, of course.
Power awaits me.
Clan Scryer.
Dreadlord. I shall destroy.
Wonder where their army went. There used to be an army there. There it is.
Death to all enemies.
Can't move this time.
Destruction.
Same with this army. Can't move. An army here. Shadowguard Warherd. Right, let's just attack. Alright, let's start the battle. Fight the battle. So they have a beast lord, and then they have some gore herds, Ungor herds, three units of Ungor herds and one of gore herds, and then they have a Ungor spearman herd and Ungor raiders. And we have Black Ark Crusaders, Leek Swords, and the Spearmen, and Black Ark Crusaders with bows, hand bows. Alright. Look at the army. Have the bleak swords here. Black Ark Corsairs. Alright. And our hero. Sarian. This is a Sarian, local hero, the Dark Elves. Right, and for murderous prowess we will need to kill 350 as usual. Allied troop count 501 of 586, so we don't have exactly a full army. Enemy troop count 661 of 661, I believe it's the land. Lowering the troop number. Alright.
Tyrant of Nagaroth.
Place them under AI control. Start the battle.
It is done.
Black Ark Corsairs are moving forward there. I think they have hand bows, so they are ranged as well. They are both ranged and melee. Here is the war herd. I wonder. Here we have some Dark Elven buildings. Here we have some beastmen. Firing their hand bows here.
Enemy units were hidden. Concealed enemy units. They were hiding.
Seems they are coming. The beastmen. Men are coming in full force here. So the Dark Elven troops are moving back there.
The enemy is charging.
Now they decided to hold their ground. troops have entered the melee. Lord has arrived. Huge guy. Big guy. Beastman of Chaos. Black or Corsairs are also fighting in melee here. We are moving forward. Our hero just used some ability on our troops, giving them some bonuses in the battle. Melee is still ongoing. It'll be a bloody fight. Hopefully we won't rout. Where their lord showed up. There is the bigger guy. I'm not sure that was a lord, so I think that was just a different type of unit. Beastmen aren't that strong. They are pretty weak, actually. But they are numerous. They have no armor. With the exception of the lord. They have some shields, but nothing else. Bigger guys over there. Fighting our troops there. They have started to rout. There's the giant guy, the lord. Killing off our troops there. They're jumped. Our troops. Wonder if we will take him down soon. Chieftain. The warherd. Troops. I wonder if he will just flee the battle or if he will die. He's surrounded too. Down! our troops. Well, his army is routing over there. Some of our troops are hunting them. He might run now. Oh, he charged again. Troops are moving in from behind. There. We kill some more troops there with that jump. He's surrounded. Hopefully we'll die soon. Someone decided to withdraw there. Some of our troops decided to withdraw. Shit, he just moves them aside. There, he took down another one. And even more of our troops. Kill a lot of troops on his own. Come on, soldiers. Feed that beast. Take him down. Are they running now? Possibly. He died! Good job, soldiers. Just take a look at the battlefield. He died somewhere here. Hard to see. Wasn't the best terrain. Take a look at the battlefield. So we have killed more than enough. Allied troop count 158 remaining. So we lost almost the entire army. Enemy troop count 71. So we have 71 left. Some routing beastmen there.
Attack! Blood for Cain! Terror and death! Death is coming! Battle loses its savor! Slaughter them! No survivors!
It went well. Battle. They turned around for a final battle here.
No mercy. Kill everything.
They weren't up to the task there. Too weak. And Lord Black are Corsairs. Equal battle that one. Their leader took out a lot of our troops, but he died at least. So I need to take a pause. I need to go and eat breakfast now. So this will be the first part, I believe. War on anyone that is close enough to our armies. Unless it's orcs. The orcs might become allies. Kuruk Man River.
Exterminate them. Release the weaklings. Kill them. Enslave them.
100%.
Let them live. I require slaves.
I need a replenishment of the troops.
Striking out. Black-hearted dreadlord. The thrill of battle.
Oh, there is solo.
Bind them. Finding my way.
Faction destroyed. Shadowgore Warherd has already been destroyed. Took it exactly one battle for them to be destroyed, so they sucked. Weapon gained. The brass cleaver. The brass cleaver is said to be an artifact from another realm. Ancient and terrible, it thirsts for blood, and Xarian received it after the battle. Still have the Ripper Horn tribe, and Manblight tribe. They were pretty weak, these guys.
Noble born. I go.
Let's move closer to this area.
Rest for the wicked. Nagaron!
Could move.
Destruction.
Here they have a plague or whatever in their own land, they have some kind of penalty for being there. Rex column. Volilor.
Retreat.
Rex siege continues.
Let
siege.
Them know death's touch. Destruction lies be- Fury.
So we have an enemy arm here. We are besieging Transcryra. They should have a garrison there. Who takes column? Clan Rat Spears. Clan Rats with Shields, Night Runners. Yeah, they have some basic stuff there.
Death to all enemies! Speak! Kill! 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 Mother of the
Murati herself there.
Favored of the Witch King. Power awaits me.
We are moving in the Lossy closer to Murati there.
I watch from the shadows. Enchanting beauty.
Alright, Malarner can upgrade something here. Alright. Stimulated growth. Damage wolves. Xarian leveled up after that victory. Let's see, go for Rout Marcher and Iron. This public order plus one. Casualties captured post battle plus 5%. Recruitment costs minus 3%. Income from looting settlements plus 4. Yeah, we need income.
Dreadlord of Nagara. Dreadlord of Nagara.
Look here, Fellheart. Corsairs, take it!
I could just walk there.
What?
Hated land walkers.
Faction is this. It's Teclas, Etain, Elven.
Sacrifices to Mathlan.
Actually.
By the cruel sea.
He will probably need to stay there for a while.
Of Nagara. Murderous lord. Set the sails.
Abandoned ship. A loaded shipwreck starts to sink as your heavy booted crew fail to take care while offloading the salvage. There's only time for one more load before they must abandon ship. For better battle, where is it? Better they can pay. Vax sealed rations. During your adventures on the high seas, You procured a bounty of rations to stave off attrition and ill health. Vax yield rations, treasury plus 1500, that's good. Alright. All right, building browser. Grand. We can build something there. Den of Outlaws will enable us to recruit shadows with spear, shadows with swords and shades, of course. Now we have only 41, we had 3000 before that. So we have Morati here. Let's move her. Red Lord. An Elven area here. Can't do anything right now.
I have prevailed.
Cruelty and violence.
So we have some treasure information there.
For Naggaroth. For
Dreadlord of Naggaroth. Tyrant of Naggaroth.
Let's move them.
I go.
Down there.
Lord of the Black Court.
Keep them as two armies. Buildings. Current car. Current car. Alright. Skip that.
My dark heart is yours.
We had an agent there that we hadn't moved.
Noxious potions. Dreadlord, awaiting command.
And an army there as well. Forgot about those. So the high elves are moving now. Grey and Veil there. They have some ships. Close to the sea towers, and now they moved past the blood swamps to the Amazons. Right, I thought it was, yeah. So they will attack me now, no doubt. And this is where I will stop recording for now. We will continue after I have eaten breakfast. Right, see ya.